Time to play with some clay. Okay, I'm gonna try to get the texture on the robe going here. I think I may have to cut off. No. I've got some different size rushes that I can attach the or get the texture on the robe without disturbing everything. I'm gonna probably move the rifle out of the way till I get that texture done. I think I got no choice but to remove the shield for a little while until I get this part of the robe done. I hate doing this. I hadn't finished. I got ahead of myself, is what I'm trying to say. I hadn't finished his arm, his bicep, and I need to do that. And I'm going to remove that as well. I'm going to texturize some areas and leave some areas smooth, only because I think it adds to the sculpture quality of the clay. Kind of like I did on the Indian woman when, in the blanket she had a while back on my video of me working on real wealth. Okay, I'm just putting a stripe on the blanket. It's a Hudson Bay blanket. I'm going to try to figure out where to put the points. A Hudson Bay blanket was graded by points. In other words, lines that marked how many points a blanket was. The higher the points, numbers, the more quality blanket was. And I think it had something to do with how many beaver pelts would buy or could be traded for a blanket. If you had 4 points, it took 4 beaver pelts to get a blanket. Something the Hudson Bay Company came up with. They still put it on their blankets today. Their blankets are very expensive. I've got one that, I don't know how many points, it's one of the top blankets, though, and it cost, I think, back 30 years ago, almost $500. Can't imagine what it is now. Made of 100% wool. I got the stripe on the other side too. Now I'll put the gun back on. Now I can put the fringe on it. do is I get a piece of clay. I don't want it too hot, or I don't want it too cold either. Because if it's too cold, it won't go through the pasta machine correctly. This makes the flat part. And if you get the right temperature, it goes through real nicely. If you get too hot, it'll bubble. Don't want bubble. And then I go through the spaghetti part. And I go slowly. And that's the way it comes out, looking like fringe. Evenly cut and everything. I don't need quite that much, but I take some of this. And I'm trying to make them all the same length. Problem is the wire is punching into the well, that doesn't make any sense. I made this is an armature I made, so it wouldn't have a piece of foam in there, so I don't know. Let me keep playing with it. I'll figure this out the next time I come back to this clay. Right now, that's as far as I'm going to get today. I'm getting frustrated. And it's not good to keep working when you're frustrated.
Yep.
So I'm going to say goodnight tonight and see you guys next time.
Give me a thumbs up and share my video. And then check out my instructional DVDs, the link down below this video. All right, see you next time.